The diamond simply light is recognition, not realization. Spirituality is not search for any kind of experience. Instead, it is a recognition of that which is and that which you already are. Value spirituality is the search for one's being that you have become aware of. Not any experience, not even for bliss, not even for ecstasy. Remember, experience is an outer technique. Spirituality is the search for that being inside you. I must know what my reality is. And with that knowing, all things are experienced. And with that knowing, there is no urge remaining, no urge to move for any new experience. With the knowing of inner truth, reality, the authentic being, all searches cease. You have arrived home, you can rest in bliss. For this, the Master does not want round around him. He wants the seeker. So what he does, he allows the disciples to be trained. And this way he disperses the time. He is making a personal contact. He is giving you an equal status spiritually, although he knows that there is much still to be done. You are simply a potential, and much work has to be done before the potentiality becomes a reality. You are the seed, but the seed has to be planted. Here to be nourished and nurtured before it can become a blossom. But whether it is a potential or actual, your spiritual status is not lower than the master. This is the meaning when master changes the disciple into flame. That is essential as well along the journey. He is giving you the recognition that you are capable just like him. Each bud has the potentiality of being a flower. But that requires a process from seed to flower. Many times people ask me, how long do I have to do it? And then I say that I was born with it. They do not understand. These are the people who are the ordinary ones. So I have to tell him that when I was born, the field was invisible. It was in the seed form. And as I grew, nourished and nurtured, the seed blossomed into a tree, and now you can see the tree. The seed has the potentiality of being a plant and then blossom into flower, but it has to go through the process. So too, there is no difference between the master and the disciple. Disciple is the one who is in the seed form, and the master is the one whose seed has blossomed into a tree. This recognition is very, very important. And this is the meaning when the master changes disciple into tree. that is essential along the journey. He is giving you the recognition that you are as capable as Him. You may not be aware, that does not make any difference. At least to Him, it does not make any difference. To you, it makes a lot of difference that you are not aware. But that is the work that you will have to do. And the work can be done more lovingly in a friendship, in love, than can be done in a certain relationship in which one is considered lower or inferior or sinner, and somebody else is considered as higher, superior, and a sinner. I do not think the reverence for such a person who meets you, his friend, will be missed. It will be missed. So do not listen to your arguments which will try to keep you in the old format of relationship. It has never been done, it is true. And you can see the result. The whole humanity is with you. So many masters and so many disciples, and the world is just in the mess. People are mad as ever. No basic change in humanity has happened. Something fundamentally has to be changed. And this is one of the fundamentals, the relationship between the master and the disciple. It has to be changed. A few dimensions have to be given to it, and once it becomes a transforming force, in the future your master will be able to go on playing the whole game. This can be a great milestone. But as far as I am concerned, it is absolutely a fact. As far as you are concerned, there are degrees. It has to be in you. 100% change from discipleship to friendship. And you will see a miracle happens because love has never been raised so much. Friendship has never been raised so high. And my whole effort is to make everything that is mundane sacred. Before me, no one has said this. Probably no one has or can have courage to say this. But this is what all Buddhas have done all along the journey. Look at their lives. You will find that they have used their bodies as vehicles. The transformation of human consciousness. He uses it according to the time and need, the awareness, but not the way of prostitutes or ignorant women. His awareness will not allow that to happen. In life, we need vehicles to move from one place to another. We need vehicles to transport yourself from one place to another. You work both for pleasure and for business. Also, you use vehicles to transport others commercially or for pleasure. In both cases, it is for transport. Certainly, it does not matter if it is for living with pleasure. In both cases, the use will be the same. A Buddha body is a vehicle, so too is your body. If he takes care of the body, maintains it, and uses it in immediate way, Buddha voice is touch. His way of looking at you, everything he uses as a vehicle to transport seekers from one place to another. Voice becomes a clarity, touch, look, everything becomes a therapy in the process of inventory.
For him, consciousness too is a vehicle and thus used to take the seekers from one realm to the next higher realm and is still higher. I was unaware of this until I left him, and so much that I realized everything that I have is ultimate bounty. Let me use it as my resources to bring bliss into the lives of those who have this dimension unexplored in them. My energy field, my vehicles will take me from one place to another as physically, mentally, psychologically, and intellectually, and finally to the deepest level. I am thankful to you for this. In myriad ways, I go on using this fleet of vehicles that existence has given me. For this, love is the most important thing. Because it is the deepest longing in you, and it is one of the most misunderstood phenomena. I say phenomena, but in fact it is an energy. Human body needs food for its nourishment, soul needs love as nourishment as well. Love is the ultimate nourishment, but not the ordinary one. Instead, it is the spiritual one. Without food, air, and water, human body cannot sustain. People live afraid. So too, without love, soul begins to shrink. But we have to have a deeper understanding of the human being. If you are in love, then love something of the divine. I emphasize, if you are in love, then love something of the divine. Love something that transcends all finite bounds. Love something for which you have to raise your eyes to reach this time. Not bring down your eyes to reach the earth. Love brings deepest contentment. Love is unseen but realized truth. One who has discovered deepest fulfillment in love is great, is very moving, is words, and is very being with all overflowing. Love will become his presence. Love's journey begins with you. You have to love yourself first. But we are too capable of loving yourself. And society, your religion, your upbringing has been responsible for creating this kind of measure. You are asked not to love yourself, to be afraid. One who has not known the art of loving himself cannot love the other. It is like somebody is standing in the river, other is drowning. You are going to save the person if you do not know the stream. Knowing oneself is like swimming. Knowing the art of swimming, knowing the art of diving. Only a person who knows pain can save the other person who is dying. You have to know the love first. Love is not love making. Love is an action. You have to discover the pleasure within. And then, once you have known how what love is, you know you have known to love yourself, then love's journey begins with you. Love yourself, And then this same love overflows through you, and you can love the entire creation. We have known love as a relationship of being. And when love is a relationship, it creates misery. When love is a state of being, your nature, then it creates bliss. A Buddha is also in love, but he is not trying to be with you. Simply because of the deity is love overflows, his voice, his gestures, his words, and through the gaps between the words, it fills you with its subtlety. Love becomes a perfume and goes to the far corners of the earth. It is a natural kind of meditation. And meditation is a supernatural kind of love. You go into the horizontal aspect of it. This never reaches to the inner depth. Become a language of love. Your voice, your words, your gestures all become the language of love. That's a perfect, which is perfect. They do not make life a rejoice. They do not need celebration. They can give you a better standard of life, but they cannot give you a new passion for you. They can give you intensity of life. They cannot give you passion. They can only give you a quantity, only the language of life, to start penetrating you through different dimensions. Certainly through the vertical dimension, you enter the dimension of love beyond the world. It is like the difference between swimming and diving. In swimming, you remain on the surface. In diving, you enter the inner depths from the same center. Between master and the disciple, therefore, with all this understanding, it is not a question of physical closeness or physical relation. Love needs no physical relation. Love needs no physical closeness. The question is of understanding what happens in the presence of the mind. In the presence of such a being, your heart starts beating in the same tune as your master's heart. Find the stuff you have called it as simple. You play one instrument and the strings of the other tuned instrument begins to resonate. Your being starts having the same form of silence as the master's being always has. This has the ingredient that brings you close to him. And when the journey continues like this, you realize that there is nothing like the realization. The moment you move to realization, the moment you ask how or why you need, there is a point not to be realized but only to be recognized. And there is how to be. Because it is already here. Just look into it.
And for this, you have to be in the silent space so that you can look. You have to be just in a moment when you are not doing anything, not going anywhere, not trying to improve upon things, just living. In that very pause, in that very relaxation, it is good. It is a recognition, not a realization. Instead of recognition, because deep down you are already and you have always been, which is because the seed, no matter, you cannot see the flower in the seed, but the gardener knows by looking at the seed. It's the final thing. So to the master is the gardener of the human. When he sees you as a seed, he knows what is your potentiality and what you can be made into. Ask how you miss again and again before, how you feel something has to be done about you. No method is needed, no path is needed, and no technique is needed. All techniques, all paths, and all methods have to be kept. You have to be in a state of practice silence so that you can hear the still small voice within you. It has been there all along. But you are so noisy with your business that you cannot hear. Your mind is so full of clatter that you cannot listen to your own inner music in your mind. You have to rely on outside music. Never ask how and drop all methods that you have accumulated to ask in heaven. Just fall into the silent space. It's a minute, not a technique. Looking at the morning sun rising, just sit silently and look at the rising of the moon. There is nothing to be done. The moon is there in the sky. Just lie down in the grass and be there with the moon. And the white clouds floating freely in the sky. Just be with them. And the birds are singing and the children playing. And you do not have to do anything. Just be passive. In your passivity, God. Be feminine. In your femininity, you come. Have you not watched it? Buddha looks very feminine, Krishna, Jesus. It is simply a metaphor. They have been depicted as feminine, and femininity has a different kind of luster, different kind of grace. To show that their inner quality is receptivity of feminine. When you are doing something, there is a certain kind of aggressiveness. When you are not doing anything, you are non-aggressive. You are passive. This state of passivity is your receptivity of femininity. Remember, God cannot be conquered. You can only allow Him to conquer you. And this process of allowing Him to conquer you is feminine. This is your essential being.